snubs. Today I want to talk about a fun event that I've had the pleasure of attending several times. It's put together by the El Dorado Winery Association, and it's called The Great Out There. This event is also referred to as the Passport event. It's a fun event they put together several times a year, and it gives you a unique opportunity to explore the various different wineries in this region. Now, it works out for me, especially considering it's in my backyard. I'm out of Sacramento, and it's also one of my top wine regions to explore that I highly recommend. I think of it often as the frontier of California winemaking. If you want to really explore artisan winemaking in California, I highly recommend you explore the El Dorado wine region. This event is put on several times a year. The last one, the El Dorado Winery Association was generous and kind enough to invite me to come out and partake in it. And while I usually take my time and explore specific wineries and for a more extended visit, what I liked about the way this was arranged, you sort of build an itinerary and you have smaller appointments and, you know, visits. So it gives you a chance to really explore. It helps bring some structure to your wine tasting experience, and you actually get quite a bit done from a wine snob perspective. The last time I was out, I explored about four wineries, and I have to say, it was a lot of fun. The event, the coordination across the different wineries was amazing, and you know, quite a few of them had food catering, and it wasn't just, you know, cheap or, you know, plain, you know, finger foods. Some of these were pretty gourmet. So I'm going to talk a little bit about my last experience, and we're going to kind of talk a little bit about the four wineries that I visited, what I liked about them, what I loved most about them, and some of my past experiences as well. So I'll put links below as well to support each of them, so you can go check them out. Some of their wines I've reviewed on Wine Snob already, and some of them I'm still in the process of discovering. So I invite you to come out with me and explore the great out there up in El Dorado. There's about 40 wineries in this region, 76 varietals, and highest altitude is about 3,500 feet. What's great about this region is the hang time on the fruit. So the ripening season is much longer, so you get these rich fruit expressions. So think wines with very intense plum, very intense cherries, berries, blackberries, blueberries, whatever that varietal's expression is going to be that much more amplified. And you also get this very unique expression of star anise and granite. And I just love that. Especially in an artisan wine, you get that beautiful layering. Very complex wines that you cannot find anywhere else. So my first winery that I explored on my last Passport Great Out There visit was Chateau Davel. That's actually what I'm sipping tonight. The Chateau Davel, I remember the first time I saw this winery. They had just opened, they were bootstrapping. It was a little shack on the side of the road. And it just tickled me in the most amazing way. I had to stop by and check it out. And the owner was out there making these little charcuterie boards. And it was just very whimsical and kind of fantasy world-like. I just loved it. And since then, that was several years ago, actually. And since then, I hadn't been back. So I took advantage of this opportunity to stop by and see how they were doing. They had a new location, and I hadn't checked that out yet. I was sort of hoping they kept the whimsical theme, and they did not disappoint. It's gonna be an awesome, unique experience. The decor is just kind of put together. It's very rustic, very whimsical, and sort of, I keep thinking Alice in Wonderland. It's a great style and a great motif. you won't find that at any other winery. They had little finger foods to pair with the wines, and the pairings were amazing. Just really great molecular gastronomy, so to speak. So that was a lot of fun. Got to meet and hang out with owner, amazing, awesome guy. You know, these are, you know, just salt of the earth folks. And I just love how the community, and I love the vibe, and I just love the very personable environment and winemaking scene overall up there. The second one that I stopped by was Madrona. This winery has been in the region, has been part of the community for quite a while, as long as I can remember, and they just make good wines. I love their, they had an amazing lineup for the Passport event, and so when I arrived for my my tasting, it was also my first time at the tasting room in estate, and I like how right in front of the tasting room there's like a, it feels like you're in the redwoods, you're in a forest. They have this cluster of trees, and the tasting room's tucked inside, and there's benches outside, and you just sit outside and you enjoy the breeze, but you still get this feeling of privacy from the trees, from the tree cover, and you sort of enjoy the outdoors as well while you taste. We went through an impressive lineup of the wines. It felt like every single wine to have, but believe it or not, they do have more. My take-homes from that day, I believe, were a Malbec and a Zinfandel. They do have a Syrah that I absolutely love. I have not been up there since, and that's going to be the next thing I'll be looking for. I happened to stumble across one with one of my other fellow wine snobs, and it was just absolutely blown away by it. After Madrona, I chose to go way off the beaten path. I like to poke around in corners less trodden, and I went out to Wofford Acres. Now, this band of you know, just folks out there are doing some amazing work. Very, very small batches. I mean, this is small even inside an artisan community. One of the things that stood out the most for me was their field blend. I always think those are fairly gutsy. You know, when you create a blend at harvest time, that's amazing. And for it to really hit the way it did, great age-worthy wines, dry, made a little more old world style, but you get the benefit of that fruit expression that I spoke to earlier. All around, really cool folks. They were grilling, had some barbecue going, and that paired well, just paired amazing with the food as well. So that was definitely an experience worth the while. And last but not the least on my day out in the great out there was at one of my favorite, up in the Camino area, and that was Via Romano. So I've been following John at Via Romano's work since he opened. He started his tasting room out there in Camino, and I just love his wines. There's something, they have a fun disposition. They're light, they have good fruit, fairly dry, and have a very broad appeal. I think my favorites from there are the Primitivo and the Fiasco. So the Fiasco is a blend, I believe, and it's probably one of his more value propositions, but it's just really so well made, very nice broad appeal. From a beginner to an advanced palate, they're gonna enjoy it. I've bought cases of the Fiasco planning to do reviews, and I literally spent years never getting around to doing a review because I would open one and just lose track of time. So I refer to his Fiasco wine as my greatest Fiasco. Vista. But yeah, check that out. They also had these amazing, they're like tapas, but very fancy, gourmet, interesting pairings and combinations, these little plates. And those all come with the passport as well. So I remember at, I think at Madrona, they had some interesting tacos that were made right there. And it was just beautiful, very tasty, delicious appetizers. At I think the highlight as far as the food went was definitely via Romano. I think I topped my tasting with an interesting cocktail. I think it was a guava. It was something having to do with guava, and it was just beautiful, subtle, nuanced, complex, perfect transition from wine tasting. All in all, it was an amazing experience. Now, some of these appointments, the calendar events usually fill up for wineries at different rates. So if you can't get into any one of these, don't worry. You don't have to necessarily go with one of these. I would highly recommend explore. Pick a winery you've never heard of. They're all guaranteed to be good. They're gonna have something interesting and something special. And sometimes you might have a pleasant surprise as far as, say, food and appetizers. And the people. You're more than likely to run into the owners, the winemakers, and the people who make it happen and share their story. All in all, it's gonna be an amazing experience. It's a great opportunity to go through and have a structured schedule and timeline that you can follow and really focus on exploring and discovering as many wineries as you can. This spans several days, so if you have the weekend open, just get up there for a couple days in a row, book a room. There's a lot of bed and breakfast, so ask around, look around, maybe Airbnbs as well. I highly recommend it. It'll be a visit worth the while. You'll get to explore a style of winemaking that actually made California what it is when it comes to wine. I highly recommend it. So for me, if you're interested in meeting up, let me know, reach out to me. These events keep going, so I'm gonna update links below on the next events as they pop up. But if you're interested in connecting with me out there while I'm tasting, if you'd like to know what wineries I'm going to be visiting on any given passport event, just reach out, give me a message, reach out on Instagram, on the blog, on Facebook, anywhere you choose to connect, and we'll get in touch. I'll give you my schedule and my dates and times, and we can meet up and we can be wine snobs together. Otherwise, definitely share your experiences in the comments below. Share them with me on email or on the blog. If you're interested in writing a feature on your experience, writing a little bit about your favorite winery, if you find some hidden gems that I haven't talked about on the blog, definitely let me know as well. I look forward to seeing you out there and hearing about your experiences. Links below on where you can sign up. And as always, try the promo code WINESNOB. You never know what surprise you might get. Until then, wine snobs, cheers.